So that's number one character in your life, or characteristics that you see in the life of a Christian brother or a Christian sister who is full of gratitude to God. Their heart is always fixed on God. Their heart is always fixed on God. It's not fixed on their bank account. You understand? It's not fixed on their connections, however important that is. It's not fixed on their political connections. Why? Because all of those things can change, brothers and sisters. The only thing that cannot change is God. The Bible says He's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. If your heart is fixed on God, it's so easy to be grateful to Him. In 1 Corinthians chapter 15, 58, 1 Corinthians 15, 58, Paul understood the truth that King David shared with us in Psalm. Paul was saying to the church, yeah, he said, therefore, my beloved brethren, he said, be steadfast. He used the word, he said, be steadfast. Why? Because Paul knew that a man who is not steadfast can't be grateful to God. Why? Because when things change, he's also going to change. When things are not going well, he's going to start to either blame the wife, blame the husband, or blame the church, or blame the society. And that's why Paul was saying, therefore be steadfast, my beloved brethren. He said, what? Unmovable. Always abounding in the work of the Lord. He said, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Say to someone, be steadfast. Say it like a minister, be steadfast. Say, be steadfast in God. Psalm 119, verse 2. Another characteristic that you will see in the heart of a man or a woman who is full of gratitude, who's always giving gratitude to God, is a blessed are they that keep his testimony. Wow. Blessed are they that keep his testimony. He said, and that seek him, what? With the whole heart. That seek God with the whole heart. There are two things there I'll have to quickly explain. Number one, he said, the one who keeps the testimonies of God is blessed. And that's why we always encourage you, brothers and sisters, to always share your testimony. Whatever it is that God has done for you, share it. You can even go a step further and even actually write it down for yourself. Praise the living Jesus. Write it down. Have a catalog for it. That's why those of us who are from Africa, yes, there are some writers that say, count your blessings, name them one by one. He said, it will surprise you what the Lord has done for you. He said, blessed is that person who keeps his testimonies. In other words, you wake up on a Sunday morning, it's the 6th of May, you say, Lord Jesus, thank you. I'm alive. I'm not in hospital. I'm not in prison. I'm not on medication. Like our brother shared, the children are doing well. The business is doing well. That's you just keeping the testimonies of God in your life. Praise God. And you find out that when you go by it like that and like that, you find out that the things that you are that God is doing for you is actually more than the things that are probably not going well for you. Make no mistake about it. We are not naive to that. We know there are some things in your life, in my life, that you still want God to do. But the point is, the thing that God is doing already is more than what He's yet to do. So focus more on what He has already done. And that gives you the lift and the faith and the strength to face tomorrow. Praise the living Jesus. He's a blessed are they that keep His testimony. And the people said that seek Him with the whole heart. Another reason why a man will always be grateful to God is when you seek God with your whole heart. And God is always particularly by the heart of a man or a woman. If you read 2 Samuel chapter 16, when God sent Prophet Samuel to go and anoint one of the sons of Jesse to become king, the Bible shows for us, when Samuel got there, the first of the son of Jesse was Eliab. He said, this is the chosen of God. You know what God said about Eliab? He said, not him. He said, I have rejected Eliab. He said, men look at the outward appearance. He said, but what I God, I look at the heart. The heart of a man is always critical to God. And when your heart is on God, always, When you serve God wholeheartedly, what do you mean by when you serve God wholeheartedly? It means God is number one to you. It means you are totally with Him. But when you are still one in, one out, then it's possible for you not to be grateful when He does things for you. But when you know that this God is my source, like David said, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord who made heaven and earth. When that has become your contemplation, when that has become all that you think about, then it's easy to give Him praise. So easy. It's so easy to be grateful to Him. When your whole heart is on Him. But when your heart is on something else, then it's difficult. And I pray that your heart and my heart will be fixed on Him. Amen. Totally, in the name of Jesus. Amen. And as we do, giving Him praise and giving Him gratitude will be an easy thing in Jesus' name.
Amen.
In Colossians chapter 2, verse 7, as I begin to wrap up this, I just wanted to remind you, it's a Thanksgiving Sunday, that it's important that we know that our heart is critical if we will always return gratitude to the God of heaven and earth. In Colossians 2:7, the Bible says, rooted and built up in Him, established in the faith, as ye have been taught, abounding therein with thanksgiving. Go by it again, it says, rooted and built up in Him. So if you see a Christian brother or a Christian sister who is always quick to give God gratitude, is a Christian brother or a Christian sister who is rooted in Christ. Is he or she is rooted in Christ. He or she is built up in Christ. And the Bible says, he had another word to it. It says, he's established. Some of your translation says, he's established in faith. And I want to quickly draw attention to that word faith. Faith is important. If you are going to be a man or a woman who is so good at giving God gratitude, you must be a man or a woman of faith. For example, when God said to Abraham in Genesis chapter 15, when he was over 90 years old, and said, Abraham, you're going to have a son. It will take faith for you to say, okay, God, I believe you. And every day you wake up and say, Lord, I thank you because the son is coming. That's faith. So faith is always a key ingredient if you will be that Christian sister or that Christian brother who will always return gratitude to God. Why is that important? It means if something is wrong with my faith, then I will have a problem giving God gratitude. A sister, a brother with a strong faith is a sister or a brother who will always return gratitude to God, who will always be grateful to God. But you see a sister or a brother whose faith is shaken, and the enemy knows that. Because the enemy knows that, he will always try to attack your faith and make your faith to be weak. Because when your faith is weak, you can't return gratitude to Him. And I pray that the God of heaven, the one to whom there is no impossibility, will strengthen your faith and strengthen my faith in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Why is it so important that our heart is right towards God? Brothers and sisters, when you have the right heart, when your heart is fixed on God, when your heart is built up with faith and every other thing that we have discussed in the past few minutes, then it means there is no room for complaint. There is no room for complaint. You are always joyful. It doesn't mean challenges are not there. The challenges are there. You are always joyful. And when your heart, when you are the brothers and sisters where such that you don't have or you don't give room to complain, it also means that you allow yourself for a new opportunity. In other words, a grateful heart, the one who has a grateful heart, will always allow himself or herself for a new opportunity, or if you like, for a new door. A new door will always open to you. How do we know that? In Luke chapter 17, it's a remarkable story many of us know. Luke 17 tells us about the story of the 10 lepers. 10 of them was healed. The one came back and said, Lord, I just want to say thank you. And Jesus, in Luke 17, verse 17, said, were there not 10 of you, Luke 17, 17, were there not 10 of you that were healed? He said, how come that one of them has returned back? And because one returned, the Bible tells us, that one got something extra. He got additional blessing. in Isaiah and said unto him, arise, go thy way. He said, what? Thy faith. See? Faith is also mentioned again as a function of gratitude. He said, your faith. It takes faith for the man to come back and say, Master, thank you. Just the word you said, my leprosy is gone. It takes faith. Whereas others probably say, well, I heard it's Jesus, so it's responsibility. So why would I need to go and say thank you to him? This man came back and said, Master, thank you. And he got something more. The Bible says he was made whole. To be made whole is more important than to be healed. To be made whole simply means that not only did this man, this woman, God is healing, he also got what we call restoration. Glory to God. It is a step higher or further than just being healed, and it's the best place to be. So it's one of them. Now, the grateful heart never complains. A grateful heart will always open doors for the new blessings. A grateful heart will always silence the enemy. When you are a grateful brother or sister, there will be no place for the enemy to operate in your life. You remember Job? The Bible tells us Job went through a lot. He went through a lot to the extent that his own wife and family members said, what's wrong with you, Job? Why not just insult this God and die? And Job made a statement that if you think on that statement as a child of God, and God gives you a revelation of him, it changed your relationship with him. In Job 13 verse 15, Job says, he said, though he slays me, he said, yet will I trust him. He said, yet, he said, though he slay me, even though I'm going through pain, things are not going the way it should be, though he slay me, he said, yet will I trust this God. Brothers and sisters, have you come to that stage? That you yourself, I myself can say, though he slay me, yet will I trust him. In other words, things are not going where you are still grateful. In other words, you went for that job interview, they said, we are sorry, you are still grateful. The bills are not paid, you are still grateful. The pastor talked to you the way you don't lie, you are still grateful. The church don't even visit you, you are still grateful. Husband or wife may not be behaving very well, you are still grateful. The children might be unruly, you are still grateful. People are mean at you at work, you are still grateful. That's what Job means. He said, don't enslave me. He said, yet will I not trust him. And I pray that that will be your mindset. It doesn't matter what you go through. You trust this God. Because the Bible says, faithful is he who has called you. Faithful is he who has called you. And I pray with these few words that God Almighty will amplify in your heart and make you a man of gratitude. And make you a woman of gratitude. And irrespective of what you are going through, irrespective of the challenge that you face, the first thing that will always come out of the man is, God, I thank you. With you, all things are possible. It's not over until you say it's over. If there's nothing else you take from today's service, remember the man who raised a woman who was dead for 12 days. If God can turn around all the chemicals for a mummy, what is your case that you can't turn around? Just be grateful. Just be grateful. What is it you are trusting him for? Just be grateful. And say, Lord, I thank you. You are never late, and you will never be late. Let's rise up on our feet as we speak to him this morning.